It was a kind of tribute and ode to Bollywood cinema. Unabashedly, sometimes it's kind of over the top. It's got tragedy, it's got love, romance, old world.
Yukti is a new girl, and I think she's got a lot of spark. Actually, Imran Hashmi ke samne koi bhi heroine hoti hai. She looks.
I don't want to take any credit for it. She's a fabulous actor.
When Tanish Bagchi can compose so well, why does he have to remake songs?
Well, I think he will take this seriously. If you see this interview, by the
way. Imran Hashmi, welcome back on Bollywood Hangama.
Thank you.
So as we speak, Lut Gaye is trending on YouTube. It was trending at number one. Now it is number two.
I believe so.
I think it has been presented as good as a movie in a way.
Yeah.
The way the mounting is.
Yeah.
Was that the attraction for you to agree to do a music video?
I mean, it begins with the song. Bhushan ji had made me hear this during the lockdown. And he said that it's a music video banana. And he also was getting very bored at home. We were all getting bored at home. We were planning stuff. And we were like, we didn't know when things will open up. But when things open up, we'll have a couple of things we can work on. So he made me hear the song and I loved it. I absolutely loved it. And my only benchmark for the song is, you know, if at the first listen, you want to compulsively hear it again and again. At least I'm like that. I would want to be part of a song like that. So yeah, and then after that, the lockdown opened up. I shot for two films and then we planned the music video post New Year. We shot it in Mumbai. So yeah.
No, I think it has been shot very nicely. Tanishq has done the music.
Yes. Tanishq has done the music. Zubin has sung it. Manoj Muntashir has written the lyrics. Directed by Vinay and Radhika. Fabulous music video. A lot of shooting. 4 days. So it was good fun.
Now, you know, there is a huge question that is facing the country right now. That when Tanishq Bagchi can compose so well, why does he have to remake songs?
Well, I think he will take this seriously. If you see this interview, I think he'll probably do more of this in the future. He should.
Because, you know, the way the entire orchestration is, the way it has been.
Yeah,
you have tremendous experience when it comes to music. You've had some of the biggest hits
in
the last couple of decades. So, the way the orchestration is and wo jo ek shiddat hai, ekdam bilkul lagta hai, Raat Fateh Ali Khan wala gana hai. So I think he should be composing more of his original stuff. He's done it in the past.
He should be. He should be. He should take this seriously. I hope he sees his interview.
All right. So tell us something about the experience of shooting for the music video. Yukti is a new girl and I think she's got a lot of spark. Actually, Imran Hashmi ke samne koi bhi heroine hoti hai. She looks.
I don't want to take any credit for it. She's a fabulous actor. They've discovered her on Instagram.
All right.
Yeah, interestingly. That's one of the avenues these days. I mean, there's so much out there, so much of talent, and they kind of hunted out from there. She's done one, I think that she's done a show before that. But they found her snaps on Instagram and they thought she fit the bill. And they called her down and she screen tested and she got the bit. And yeah, a very interesting concept. I was taken through the storyboard by both Vinay and Radhika in December. Very meticulous. I loved the fact that it was a kind of tribute and ode to Bollywood cinema. Unabashedly, sometimes it's kind of over the top. It's got tragedy, it's got love, romance, old world kind of romance. But also aesthetically presented very well. So that was at least rest assured that visually we have a stunning music video. And it's got everything in it. It's like a potboiler. And it's difficult to kind of put everything in those 4.5 minutes, which I think they have done beautifully.
Okay, now you've been part of some really amazing romantic songs. The chemistry that you managed to develop with your heroines is something which is tremendous as well. I've spoken to quite a few actresses who have worked opposite you. They have great things to say about you. As a co-star, you may be having this image of this hero who kisses on screen, but otherwise, actresses.
COVID.
Not anymore, but I think that will stick.
I've retired.
And, but your heroines, they have great things to say about you, that he's a complete gentleman. Now, what is it that you feel with your experience is required to get that comfort level of your heroine so that, you know, they are comfortable, so that when the chemistry, and they should feel for you, so that when the chemistry is coming out visually, it's believable for the audience.
You feel for me for those few minutes for the shot, I'm guessing. Yeah.
Yes.
I guess a comfort level is extremely important. I have been, I'm not going to name instances on film sets where, you know, sometimes actors don't get along with each other and it just becomes a chore and becomes very cumbersome working on those kind of film sets. So I try to keep it casual, like to keep it fun. I think that's what works. I think also making them feel at ease, because a film set can be extremely daunting and intimidating, especially for newcomers, especially for a song like this, I mean, where you have a girl who's facing the camera on this scale. It's important to just kind of make them feel comfortable. That's about it. And just be clear about what you're putting out there. Yeah.
All right. Now, you said that there are occasions when just being a part of a film is not really a great experience because you know it's not really going in a certain direction. So, I spoke to Pankaj Tripathi and he said that hame pata chal jata hai film ka beech mein kabhi kabhi certain films mein ki that ye ek sahi disha mein nahi ja rahi hai. To hum phir is tarike se karte hain ki hame involvement to rakhna hai, to phir hum plan karte hain ki aaj raat mein hum khane mein kya khayenge. So, that keeps us interested. What is your way of dealing with such situations?
Well, I don't completely disconnect in that sense. I still keep a little bit of hope going that things can be salvaged. And that's my thing. If I disconnect, I snap ties. So like I'm either on or off. Then it affects my work. I think some actors can be a little disconnected and work and know that, okay, this is not going in a certain direction. And, you know, but I need to have that kind of involvement through and through. Ultimately, what happens to the film after it releases, how it's made, that no one really has complete control over. And you know, these synergies of all these talents coming together, you know, like I always say, har film ke kundli hoti hai. Everyone comes with the best of intentions to make a good film. But sometimes films are, they turn out to be good films. Sometimes it just doesn't work. That melody is not in sync. Something is completely off. And it's not got anything to do with the intentions of the people who are working on that film. It just sometimes it goes completely off. That vision just takes a full toss into a different direction. But I just always try to hold it in, you know, kind of rein things and trying to see how much control I can have over it to kind of see it through. That's what I do. I know some actors who completely disown films if the film turns out to be disastrous and not up to the mark. And sometimes people tell me, oh, how are you promoting this film when, you know, you don't completely believe in it? I mean, as in, it's not turned out the way you feel it was intended to be. But I just feel a sense of responsibility and ownership on that product. I feel bad that, you know, I should take it through. It's the experience sometimes, it's not the outcome. I'm in on this ride and let me complete it to the best of my ability. That's my...
We've discussed that in the past, that the sort of taste that you have in terms of reading and the sort of movies that you personally like to watch and quite a few films that you've been part of, there's quite a dichotomy over there. But you've learned, I think, to just understand the fact that a hit film is a hit film. And it helps to be a part of a hit film.
Of course it does. Of course it helps to be part of a hit film. I mean, there's one thing of being praised for performance and all that, that's all great. But when you're part of a successful venture, that's when you benefit the most from a film. That there's no two doubts. There's no two ways about it. There's no doubt about that.